Well, hello. This is Madeline from Madeline's Craft Room, and I am here tonight for a stamping as we are going to do a step it up, which means we're going to start with a simple card and then we're going to step it up. So we're making two cards tonight. And if you are joining me by live, be sure to comment. And if you're new to me, be sure to tell us where you're from, as it's so fun to see people from all over the place. So that is a wonderful thing about technology. So, yes, we'd love you to join. And if you're catching me later on the replay or on YouTube, be sure to comment because you are entered in a draw. But yes, I am Madeline from Madeline's Craft Room, and I am in Parksville, Vancouver Island, BC, Canada. And I am a Stampin' Up! Demonstrator. And tonight we are going to feature this cute little set called the Fluffiest Friends. It's one of our online items, and I haven't made too many cards with it yet. I have used the cute little kitty cat. But I'm a bunny lover, so I decided tonight I'm going to do a bunny. I need some baby cards, so I thought this would be a cute one for that. And oh, there's Wendy. Hello, Wendy. And so you can see this is quite the collection of different animals. This is really cute with the bear because the dies actually have a beehive and branches and leaves, and of course, the grass. And then we have the beaver and a bird and a cat and the cute little, I believe it's a little hamster. So really, really, really cute. Hello, Jenny. There she is. So tonight, we're going to just stick this over here for now. And we are going to stamp on this paper here. And we're going to start off by using our black Memento ink. And I just want to, bouncing all over. Now, that's right. I got to put it up here. I was going to use the pink. See? There we go. Now, let's see. I don't care really where I put it. I'm just going to put it down anywhere on that white scrap. Close up this one. Okay. And so the first thing we're going to do is just give this a little bit of color. And we're gonna, because this one we're gonna keep quite simple. So I'm not gonna do any fancy coloring with this one. Remember, open your blinds, give it support as you push up, and then that way it will keep your blends a lot better and the cartridge won't pull out, as that has been definitely an issue. So, one way to stop that from happening. So, I'm just going to put a little bit of the light first. And then I'm just going to put a little bit of dark right here, just to leave a little bit of color difference. And I think I'm going to do his little feet too, his little pads on his feet, just because we want a little bit of color on him. And Stampin' Up! Has already marked the areas that we want a little bit darker. And so those are the areas that I am inking up. And then I go usually back over it again with a little bit of light. And that's all we need for the pink. This is bubble gum or bubble bath, pardon me. I always would say bubble gum. Okay, now I want to keep this pretty neutral. So I am not going to use the two, the dark and the light. I am going to just use a little bit of the smoky slate. And this is the light, right? Let's just double check. Yes, the light. I'm not going to use the dark because I am actually just going to go around the edge here a little bit. And with that, instead of blending it with another color, I'm actually going to take the color lifter. And I think it will help us blend it just a little bit, just so it's not so stark. Okay, we'll go back. And I don't usually do too big of spaces at one time because when you do that, then the ink dries. And this is alcohol ink. And alcohol ink, in order for it to blend, It needs to be wet. So I'm just going to go a little bit around here like that. How are you ladies tonight? Okay, I'm just gonna go like this around here and around here. Let's see. Again, Stampin' Up! Says to go here and here. All right. Anybody played with this set? It's kind of nice that, you know, we all seem to have our favorite animals. So it's nice that you can choose between the cat and the bunny. And of course, some wild animals, which is nice. Where did I see? I missed a spot. I saw one here somewhere. No, I think it looks good. Hello, Vicky. There she is. All right. So now we're just doing a little bit of coloring because we're starting with our simple card here. So now I am going to, let's see, I think I'm going to make the yellow paper because I don't think yellow icing would look too good. And then we're going to have the cherry on the top. Look at the cute little detail even on his little cupcake. So there's the little cherry. So no fancy blending there with that one. Okay, so now I've moved things around on my desk, so I've kind of been going different places with my hand to find the right spot. Boy, we're creatures of habit, aren't we? I've been changing some things here in my craft room, and especially with the new catalog leaving, or the new catalog coming and the old one leaving. I have been doing some changes here. I haven't taken down my displays, but I've been preparing so that we'll be ready for when that change happens, because that will be May. And hard to believe we're already into April. So I want to be all ready because I want to be able to show you all the exciting stuff. I don't have any of the new product quite yet. But it will be coming next week, as I did do a pre-order. So I can't wait. So there we've got this cute little bunny. We're going to put him there. And now this is just our normal white cardstock. And what we're going to do here is I'm going to open up Bubble Bath ink pad. And we're going to put it there. And then I am just going to take my blending brush. And this is what's nice about the glass mat. You can dab off and you're not wasting on the paper. But basically, I just want a little circle. Oh my goodness, it's not going to have much color. Oh, all righty. How about that? I'm going to have to press hard. Guess what I need to refill? I think I need to re-ink my stamp. That's okay. I didn't think this one would need it. I do like Bubble Bath, so yes, it shouldn't surprise me. Of course, this is fairly new, but then of course we've got all the new colors. Oh boy, those colors look so yummy and delicious. Okay, so I'm just going to put, and then I'm just going to go out a little bit just so that it's not going to be quite as white. So we're going to do that. Okay. Now, I thought what would be cool is to, first of all, let's see, should we put it on his, maybe on his cupcake? Put a little bit of Wink Estella. Boy, this has been an item that they've been having a lot of trouble keeping up with, but it looks like they have it resolved, and we should be getting it soon. But I'm going to try, actually I'm going to close this up. I am going to try flickering some Wink Estella on there. So I'm just tapping it on a pen, And then we're gonna get some glimmer on there. Some big dots, little dots. Okay, I think that looks good. Let's see if I can show you what it looks like. I don't know if it's gonna show. Probably it's not gonna show too much. No. Well, you can see a few spots there, but you can't see the shimmer. So you'll have to try it sometime because it really looks really cool when you do that. Okay, so now we need a sentiment because we got our cute little bunny. Okay, and we're gonna take the black memento out again. And like I said, I am needing some baby cards just for some variety. So I'm gonna use this one, which comes from, what's it called? Celebrating You. And I love the variety that comes in this one. So many wonderful sentiments. And of course, this one even includes Welcome Little One. So I'm gonna stamp that on there. Close this up again. Okay, now we're gonna bring things in because like I said, I am going to keep things pretty simple here because it is one of our simple cards. And it's okay to do it simple. So I think I'm actually even gonna keep it flat for this one. I do find it hard, I gotta admit, to keep things simple. I am so used to doing advent cards, but you know what? It is really good to practice and do some simple ones because sometimes we push ourselves too much if we want to do something where we want to make a whole bunch. We don't have to make it so fancy. So here, we're going to put the little bunny. Oops, let's move it up a little bit more. Put that away. Okay. And I see, where am I? Then I'm going to use these. I believe these are going, but I love these because they have the gold and a blue and the bubble bath. So I'm just going to take a few of these sticky back sequences, and I am just going to, let's see, put one there and maybe one down here. All right, so there we have the number one card. Simple, isn't he a very cute little bunny? Just love it. Okay, let's step it up. So the next one we're going to do here, I'm going to just step it up, taking this time pretty much the same materials, but we're going to just add a little bit more detail. So we're going to take, again, our cardstock, our white cardstock, and then I am going to use this one here. So have you seen this one with the detail? This one is fairly new for me, and I love the detail because I am sad that the contour dies are leaving, so I've had to retrain my brain as to, okay, what else can we use to get detail? And I must admit, I like that detail. So this is the dies that come in with it. I even love that there's a heart with that one and then two circles. So this is really cool. This is called radiating stitch dies. So we're going to take this as our basis, and am I going to go this way? I think we might even go landscape. I'll show you kind of what I'm thinking here, but I want an opinion. You guys can help me here. So I'm also taking, well, I actually could do two. Where did I put it? I lost it. Must be in here. Nope. Okay, then it's here. So should we use this one? Hello, Linda. We could use this one, which is matching this set, or we could use this one die from the Everyday Details. So which one do you like better? Which one should we use? The one with the poke or the holes all the way around, or this one with the notches? or notches, the little, I don't know what you call those, sort of like the, well, it is a matching die to this one. So let me know, first of all, which one do you like? And then it helps us decide our next step. Anybody got an idea which one we should use? No ideas? Because we want to be able to use this one. So let's have a look. Let's take one more look, ladies. We have this one or this one. This one kind of has more of an impact, doesn't it? Maybe we might go with that one. Nobody else have another idea? Okay. So what we're going to do here is we would color the bunny the same way. And just to save time, I have already done the little bunny. And so what we're going to do is we're going to, not right now, but we're going to pop him up. But first I thought it would be nice to put some flowers, because did you notice that in this stamp set, it also includes some cute little flowers. So I need a new block. Guess all my other blocks. Oh, no, it's okay. So what we're going to do here, I'm going to step them, push them up a little bit, just because as you see here, this is some of the dies that came in there. And I love it when stamp sets have everything you need to make a really cool little picture, little story all on its own. So we're going to stamp some flowers there. And let's see, and then we're going to cover it up here with some grass. But let's see, we got to color our, we'll color them all. How about pink and yellow? So let's color. I know daisies are white, but we're going to make these yellow flowers just because I want a little more color. And I just realized I didn't get out my green, but that's okay. I got my green. Granny apple? That sounds good to me. Okay, so let's try the pink. So ladies, do you ever try stepping up your card? Start with something simple and then step it up? Or you like to keep it all simple? Or a little bit of both? Or I know I tend to spend too much time on my cards. That was kind of like me in scrapbooking too. And I've really had to be learning to keep it more simple, because you can get a nice effect with simple, but it doesn't take as much time, and then you get to do more. You always make it, oh, hi, Penny. You make it complicated too. I know. We're famous for that, aren't we? So now I'm going to glue this little, Penny, do you do scrapbooking as well or just card making? I used to do a lot of scrapbooking, and then actually even last year I did offer, scrapbooking class, and then there wasn't as much interest, so I kind of got away from it. But I don't know if you just cards right now, that's okay, that's enough, isn't it? So I think I'm going to pop the bunny, but before I do that, I am going to okay, I think I might even just put this above. Let's see if Madeline can get the straight. Normally what I do is I stamp first so that if I do a boo-boo, I haven't ruined it, but look, it's straight. We're good. So there we go. But yeah, you've probably been hearing that close to my heart. It's very sad that the company is closing, and the makers, I can just only imagine how that's been so difficult for them if they've been doing it as a business for so long and all of a sudden it's the end. And I'm so pleased that Stampin' Up! Has stepped up and trying to find ways to be able to accommodate and help the makers to be able to effectively sign up with Stampin' Up! And also that they're going to provide scrapbooking stuff for us. So I'm very excited about that. Very, very excited. Okay, so here's one more question. Are we going to put the ribbon on? Should we put the ribbon on? Because if we're going to put the ribbon on, we need to do that now. I think maybe it will add something, hey? We put the ribbon on there. I always like to attach it in the back because then you don't see, you don't see the front and you don't see the glue dot. So we're going to go like this. I think we're going to kind of keep it to that line there. I guess I could have used a little less. Okay. Why is it not sticking? Because I'm not pushing hard enough. There we go. Okay. Now we can glue this on because I think I'm going to pop this. So we're going to put our glue on this side. And I always put a little bit by the glue. It's just in case the ribbon doesn't want it here, then you've got some more adhesive there. But then we're going to take this one and put it on here. Now, this wouldn't have to be, obviously, a baby card. It could be a birthday or hello or thinking of you. It could be whatever you like. But I am going to make it a little baby card. Now, what did I do with it? Here. So we're going to pop this one up and actually, and then we'll just go back and look at the two of them. So love to see if you have made anything with this cute, adorable set, this bundle. I would love to see it. I love seeing ideas. So I think I'm going to put it like that. And then I think I may even tie a ribbon. So let's just quickly. I do like this ribbon. It seems to really tie nicely. Sometimes when it's too thick and it makes it a little bit harder, but I think this one is really nice for the tying bows. Okay, so I think what will we do? Put it underneath the bunny? Maybe underneath the bunny. So where's my glue dots? See, you don't put things back where they're supposed to, then you can't remember. So there, we're gonna get the glue dot on the ribbon. And we're going to just put him there like that. Oh, and now we need, don't forget, we need some embellishments. I think I got three on here, so let's do that. So, ladies, let's see. What one there. And one down here. Where? Maybe one over. Maybe one there. Okay, let's have a look. So I kept with the same colors Because I wanted to be able, and the same stamp set. So I just wanted you to be able to see how you just do a little bit more and step it up. But there you go. Cute little bunny, but two very different ways. So let me know which one is your favorite. And I thank you for joining me. And I'm just looking, anybody commenting yet? Nope, not yet. Let me know. And if you are catching me on YouTube, be sure to like and subscribe. And also on Facebook, then if you follow me and like my videos, that helps me to be able to get my videos out more as well. You like the pinker one. I know, me too. It is pretty adorable, isn't it? All right, ladies. Well, thank you very much for joining me and have a good rest of your evening. Bye for now. I'm gonna find my mouse.